Hey everyone, thanks for being here and welcome to my first episode of Friday Night Live. Yes, I know it's the most original name ever made, but I appreciate that you're being here. And I'll talk about how this is going to be different than my regular streams. Spoiler alert, not too much different, but I appreciate you being here. So as we all fill in, and file in. Yes, and Carol, I saw your message. I hope you do find a place in the next couple months. I know we have our chat on Sunday, so maybe we can talk a bit more about it on Sunday. But for everyone that's in here, why don't you put in the chat something about where you're watching from tonight. I see a lot of familiar names. Where you're watching from and what you expect tonight. Let's do that. So a two-part question. Is where are you watching from tonight, and what do you expect? Where are you from, and what do you expect tonight? So let's see, Dexter. Nice to see you. So we got Kel from Vancouver. Fangirl says Northern BC and not a lot. Well, perfect. I should be able to fulfill that, Fangirl. Dexter, I expect this to be a good stream in Nanaimo. Well, of course, you know me, I know you. This will be a good stream. Carol, I'm watching from Penticton. I expect some fun. That sounds good. That sounds good. Hey, everyone. Welcome. Once again, as you file in here, type in where you're from and what you expect from tonight. And I'll get started in about a minute. Coach Rob, my condo in Esquimalt. I hope to have some good laughs. Okay. Well, I'm not a stand-up comedian, but yes, we'll see what happens. That'll partly be up to you guys. Cole, East Richmond and some entertainment. Cole, my buddy from my own parish of St. Paul's in Richmond. Nice to see you. Edmund, I'm bummed. I'm excited to go to the game tomorrow, but I'm sorry to hear that, Edmund. I'm sorry to hear that. I wasn't supposed to go, but I'm disappointed for everyone that was supposed to. Kel, something that will make me forget about tomorrow's postponed game. Well, I guess that didn't help that I just mentioned it. So, okay, keep typing it in. Reaction Club, I would like to start off by paying my condolences to legendary comedian Betty White, who passed away at age 99. Yes, that's true. And legendary actor Sidney Poitier, Mr. Tibbs, yes, age 94. Yeah, they're two legends we lost this week. Dexter, I expect you to run around the block in only your underwear screaming Go Canucks. Well, Dexter, I appreciate if you keep your fantasies out of this, please. Marjorie, Heikley, I was supposed to also go to the game. Oh man, no, I'm sad too, you guys, for you. Tanner, Lower Mainland, Canucks Pedersen still struggling. That's what you expect, Tanner? Michael, random phone call segments. Well, Michael, I'm glad you're here, Michael. Michael, did you know that that you won the post-game contest? I'm not sure if you're on my stream on Sunday night. But Michael, you won the post-game contest. So I need your email address. So Michael, can you email me at clayemo@shaw? I just typed it in the chat. But yes, Michael, I want to give you a $50 gift certificate to Van Base. So that's because if you are the same Michael, wait, confirm Michael, you are the same Michael that always responds to my post-game videos. Correct, Michael? If that's you, then make sure you email me for sure. Because I have a gift certificate to give you because you did win on Sunday night. Noah says, looking good as always. Well, thank you, Noah. I'm sure you look good as well, even though I can't see you. Jason, let's do this. Can't believe we now have to wait until Tuesday. Yes. And it'll be 9 straight road games. Yes. Coach Rob, was that also the game that Lucas... Yes, Lucas was supposed to go to that game too, using his legend game from Jason. Yes. Justin, hi Clay, hi everyone. Just got on my way home from work at Rogers. The Warriors are playing like the Oilers tonight. No defense, no goaltending. Blew a 10-2 and lose 18-15. Justin, how was the crowd there? And did you feel safe working there? Thanks for being here. Fangirl says hello. Michael, that was you. All right, make sure you email me, Michael, and I can... congratulations. Okay, let's get started. I am Canuck Clay. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club. And this is Friday Night Live. I'm going to try doing this for a little bit. I have my regular Sunday night live stream at 10, my Wednesday night live stream at 10. I have Canucks After Dark with Parker at 10. And then now I'm going to try this on Friday nights at 11. And I'll get to the reason why in a second, and then I'm going to get all to your comments and stuff. I want to give a shout out right away to my moderators in advance. Thank you in advance. We'll see how busy you are tonight. I don't expect it to be any different just because it's Friday or just because it's a bit later. So thank you in advance, moderators. Thank you to my sponsors, Perform and Transform, personal training and weight loss. You can sign up now, as always, for a free 7-day trial. Use the link right on the screen, performandtransform.ca/CanuckClay. I want to thank Jason Lim and Van City Experts Real Estate Group. You know how much Jason takes care of me and takes care of us in the stream. So thank you, Jason, for being here. To Gassy Jack Art and to Monkey Nine Brewing, my eternal sponsor, I appreciate you, them as well. To my members, legendary Lucas Gates, legendary Justin Credible, and legendary Andrew Chang. To my hero members, Nux Fan number 29 and Carol Bovenlander. Hall of Fame members, Jens 95, Sim Alexander, Chris Seifert, Adam Broomfield, Shannon Hollingworth, and HSM Fangirl Gaming. Many of you guys in the chat tonight, I appreciate you as well. And most importantly, no matter where you're watching from, whether you're in my beautiful neighborhood of Steveston and Richmond and Lower Mainland, in the province, in the country, on the continent, or around the world, thank you for being here. I do not take you for granted. I know that you could be doing anything. Well, maybe not. It's Friday night at 11. Who are we kidding? But the fact that you are here with me, hanging out with me, I appreciate you, and I certainly do not take you for granted. And if you want to subscribe, please subscribe. If you want to like this video, please like this video. If you want to do any of that good stuff, donations or whatever, I certainly accept those as well. But most importantly, I am happy that you are here. I'll answer the questions real quick, and then I'll get to why I'm doing this. Tanner says, will the Canucks make the playoffs? They have a chance. They only have to go 28-17-3. They need 59 points in their final 48 games. And yes, the road trip will tell us a lot. Hello, J-Kid, Andrew. No, you didn't miss anything. We did a few intros and stuff, but that's it, Andrew. I'm not sure if you got in time to hear me say your name. And Fangirl says, Clay, if you had to pick the ability to use Spider-Man's web shooter to web someone you know or a random person for 1 hour, to web someone you know or a random person for an hour, I would want to web someone I know, because if there's someone I don't like, I can web them, I think. Okay, I'm going to stop. If you had to pick the ability to use Spider-Man's web shooter to web someone, yes, I would pick someone I know for sure. What's the fun in doing someone random? Edmund, I'm going to get to your question in a second. Okay, and last question, and then I will stop answering for a second. How are the Canucks going to make up all these games that have been postponed? They have a 3-week break that was supposed to be for Olympics, and they can also extend the season for a week afterwards. Okay, so why am I doing this Friday Night Live? Well, a couple of reasons. Something different, and I'll explain how they're going to be different in a second. I'm usually not doing anything on Friday nights at 11. I'm not sure if you guys are either. And part of the being different is I'm not going to make these actually shows Canucks related. And I'll get to that in a second. And so it's a chance to get to know me a little bit more than you would on a Sunday night or a Wednesday night. And it's also, just a chance to be a creative on this channel and continue to build our community. So those are the main reasons why. And we'll try it for a little bit and see how it goes. And if no one comes, then I'll stop doing it. Easy. And if people like it, then I'll keep doing it. Easy. So 3 big changes between tonight's Friday Night Live and, say, my regular Sunday or Wednesday streams. By the way, you guys know that I'm a bit of a night owl, which is good, although it's not great for my rest. And it was funny when Parker and I we have a good thing going with Canucks After Dark. We're over 1,000 subscribers now, which is pretty cool. That channel is growing as well. But when Park and I first started talking, I told him that I could only do late nights, and he's more of an early night guy because he's an early morning guy. And then when we were coming up with the name, it was pretty seamless, actually, when one of us suggested the name and the other guy agreed pretty quick, because it's a I can say that I suggested Canucks After Dark, and he liked it right away. And he said that he was thinking about a similar name. So I'm not taking credit. We both kind of thought of it. So then I could actually call this Canuck Clay After Dark, but I didn't want to make it look like I was just copying Canucks After Dark, even though we came up with the name. Friday Night Live. I'm a big fan of Saturday Night Live. And of course, this is live. This isn't pre-taped. Well, most of it's live. So hence the name of the show. And 3 big reasons why I'm doing this, or three reasons why this is going to be different. Deuceman says, hi, Clay, good night, cheers. Thanks for being here, Deuceman, for like 30 seconds. Number one, how's this different from my other streams? It's not going to be Canucks focused. So I will read all your questions and chat comments as much as I can, And I'm not going to break it into Canucks questions and then ask me anything. No, the whole thing is going to be ask me anything. So you can put Canucks questions in there or you can put other questions in there. It doesn't matter. So that's the first thing. Number two, I want to try new things. So tonight I'm going to show two different videos because you guys seem to like it when I show videos. Once in a while, I'll play a game or have a contest. No game tonight, but once in a while, I'll throw a game up, whether a Kahoot or something like that, or an online game, or that stupid Wordle game that's sweeping the internet right now. Tried it for the first time tonight. And yes, I will be calling two of you tonight. So I'll get to that in a few minutes. So I'm going to try new things on Friday night, stuff that might not fit on the Sunday night or Wednesday night, but Friday night, be a little bit more creative. Maybe it's having a guest on, whether through Zoom or one of my family members or whatever. So tonight, we'll do some videos. We'll do some calls as well. The third thing to answer, I think it was Edmund's question. I'm not going to put a time expectation. I could go for as little as 30 minutes. It'll never be less than 30 minutes. Probably closer to 45 when I think about it. But I don't have any expectations that I have to go for 45 or an hour. Who knows? If it's going well and my family's asleep, I could go for 2 hours. I could go for 45 minutes. So I'm not going to put in an actual end time. But my guess tonight is that we'll end between 45 and an hour. But that's the smallest of the three differences. Because now that I think about it, in fairness to you, I don't expect you to hang out for as long as, you know, to keep on going. So maybe for tonight, I'll end it by midnight. I think that's a good time. So because I do got to get some sleep. So maybe we go for about an hour tonight. But the two more important differences is not going to make it Canucks focus. And I'm going to try and be a bit more creative with these things and try some new things. So just having said that, we're going to try one of those new things now. So I have a chance to show you some videos and I'm going to do so right now. As I move my, anytime you see me move my little icon on myself, you know that I'm setting up for a video. So let's do that right now. Some of you have seen this before. And so one of these, I'm going to show you two videos tonight. And here's the first one. Don't worry, they're all not all going to be my music, but this one is because I really want to show you this one. This is a commercial that I was hired to do with my good friend Ariel. Now, most of you know my parody partner mostly is Marie Huey, but we've also done some songs together, me, Marie, and Ariel. I've also done a few collaborations with Ariel herself. Ariel is a fabulous actress, dancer, and singer. Many of you have seen her sing. She's part of the Larshiders. She actually has sung anthems at Canucks games, at Whitecaps games, and some other sporting events. So she's a very good singer as well, just like Marie. And we got hired to do a commercial. So this is at a Lazy Boy store. This is a parody of Iggy Azalea's song called Fancy, I'm So Fancy. This is I'm So Comfy. So enjoy this quick 2 minute video, Comfy.
First things first, I'm the realest. Drop this and let the lower man then feel it. And I won't tell you mind your business. You can sit down and we can watch some hockey physics. Right. You should want a cool couch like this. Huh. Make you want to sit and chill just like this. Yeah. Urban attitudes, young and hip. Sophisticated, modern, it's a comfort bliss. Please. Watching the Canucks games, cheering on the boys. Screaming hockey fans sure make a lot of noise. While I lounge and sit in my Lazy Boy. To live life comfortably is my choice. I'm so comfy, you already know, so relaxing, shoes off, throw them on the floor. I'm so comfy, go Canucks, go, I'm watching my team scoring goals. Now let's go, let's do this, I thought that you knew this, don't have a Lazy Boy, now that is just foolish. From North Van to Richmond, Langley, Coquitlam, furniture, garage, I can't shop at no department, but sofa with flip, or the recliner or chair, all perfect for watching the hockey game over there. Better get the sofa with flip, or the recliner or chair. And when we're not sitting, you know we're gonna stand up and cheer. Now are you hazy, hazy, crazy, crazy? You better watch the Canucks in a lazy, lazy. It's the Lazy Boy. Put the name in bold. Lifestyle and comfort is the way to go. I'm so comfy. I'm so comfy, go Canucks, go, I'm watching my team scoring goals.
Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. I want to show you one thing. This is actually where one of my gifts came from before the famous thumbs up gif. This is where I almost broke my leg. So you guys watch this one more time. So comfy, you already right know. Here. So you can see this is already going to end very badly because my left leg did not clear the whatever you call that, the ottoman or the hassock or the footrest. So yes, that is my left leg bending underneath myself, and then I actually land on it. Watch this. So that actually, the camera didn't catch it, but it's actually bent in a weird kind of way. So if we watch it one more time, you can appreciate my athleticism or unathleticism. So we got Ariel jumping on the couch, she looks fine. And then look at this. You already know, so relaxing. Shoes. Yes, that is your boy, Knut Clay. Okay. Let's get to some of your comments now. Thank you for watching that. I appreciate it. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I saw some comments saying some of you have seen this before and you enjoy it. Thank you. Others saying that's your first time watching it. So similarly, I hope you enjoyed that as well. Yeah, we had a lot of fun making that. And Coach Rob, to answer your question, that was 2015. So that was 6 years ago. So let's get to some of your questions and comments. I won't do it for this one, and I'll give you a warning, but I have a feeling like once in a while we'll watch a video of mine or something else I find in that. But I'm a little self-centered. I like watching my videos because you can watch anyone else's videos anytime. I guess technically you can watch my videos anytime. But I have a feeling of one time we'll do a contest where we'll watch one of my music videos, and then we'll do a quick like 10 question pop quiz on Google or whatever, and then the winner will get a prize of some sort. So we're not going to do that tonight. But that's another thing that we could do. Okay. So Fangirl says, I enjoy this parody every time I see it. RJ, I haven't seen this one. Sick. I think that's what he said. Sick. Reaction Club says, I've seen this. It's hilarious. JGP, flame, flame, flame. Bring in the heat. Brian says, LMAO, awesome commercial. Thank you. Fangirl agrees with Reaction Club. What year was this made? 2015. Canucks Anthem? Sure. Why not? And, oh, Alfren. Thank you for the donation. The first ever donation in Friday Night Live. Let the record show. It was done by my good buddy, Alfren Ordanza. Hey, Clay, I love your music video there. Thank you, Alfren. Let's get some love for Alfren in the chat for sure. Carol, I love when Carol calls me Play. I think it's because she's using talk to text and or she thinks my name is Play. Carol, that's awesome. Oh, there it is, Clay. This is so awesome. What a great commercial. Thank you. Ariel was great. Ariel's got a really good voice for this kind of song. And she's also a really good rapper. So I thought she was good. So the usual, I wrote the lyrics. We used an instrumental. My brother helped me mix the song. And then Ariel did the singing. And then we shot that at a Lazy Boy in Coquitlam, I believe. Travis Clay, missing the couch was gold. Thank you. Joe says, great. Kel says, oh yeah, this was the one my friend recommended. Awesome. Thank you, Kel. And thanks to your friend. Andrew says, awesome. Legendary Andrew. Shannon, I love that one. Thank you, JGP. Overshot the couch by a bit. Well, that's what happens when you have such an amazing athletic ability that I do. I almost killed myself. I shouldn't say that. I almost hurt my leg. Andrew, yikes, I can see it. Fangio, this one is funny. I agree. Andrew, ouchie. Sebastian, hey, Clay, happy Friday. I haven't watched your video about the game suspension yet. Sorry. No problem. No need to apologize. How much do you think revenue and finances had to do with the decision? Yeah, a lot. And it's all mixed together, right? The revenue finances, the COVID, because we can't have more than 50% because of COVID. If you bring 9,000 people together, you still have run the risk of running a super spreader event, even though people are vaccinated. We can't overrun the hospital system right now. So it's a combination of both. It's not just money. It's not just COVID. It's a combination of both for sure. Coach Rob said that was good. JGP out 4 to 6 weeks. Yes, lower body injury. Got to be more careful. Thank you, Brian. Great video, by the way. Thank you, Sebastian. Fangirl, life in a cast isn't fun. Oh, I did not know you were in a cast. That stinks. Arso, what up, everyone? Hi, Clay. How do you misjudge the couch by that much? I'm not sure what I was thinking, actually. It was like many things that I do, I kind of shoot first and ask questions later. So literally, I ran. I wasn't running super fast, but I jumped. And I think in midair, I realized, uh-oh, I'm either not going to clear this footstool or no, there's no other option. I'm not going to clear this. I don't know what I was thinking. And even if I did clear it, what was I going to do? Was I going to, because of the way my angle, the angle of my body, it's not like I was going to land on my feet and stand up straight. Yeah, I'm not sure what I was thinking there. Andrew Clay, could be a torn ACL, MCL. That could have been bad. 2015 was 7 years ago. See, Reaction Club, it's late. I don't know my math. Oh, yeah, we're in 2022, right? Yes, thank you, Reaction Club, for that correction. 7 years ago. Justin Credible, the Vancouver Canucks have placed legend Clay Emo on the injured reserve. Takes one to know one, legend. Thank you, Justin. And thanks again, Elfrin, for the donation. Elfrin hype? Yes, for sure, for sure, for sure. And we're doing well. Thank you, Elfrin. Hello, Tyler. Jogpa, will Rathbone get another shot this season? I presume so. I think I would play him over. Actually, Boudreaux hasn't seen him yet. I would play him over Burrows and Hunt, actually. I think, let's say Hamonic's back. I think Rathbone's the seventh best defenseman on the team. Between Oyel, Myers, Hughes, Hamonic, Shen, Pullman. I play him over Burrows and I play him over Hunt. I really do. Shannon Hickley, one question, and that is, do the Canucks have a taxi squad? Oh, the Canucks do have a taxi squad, but do they also have a BC Ferry squad or a motorhome squad? Yeah, right behind the bicycle squad and stretch limousine squad. Thank you, Shannon. Great question. That was pretty funny, actually. Knucks and Bolts, Dexter, next week will not be Go Canucks Go, but Roar Canucks Roar. Knucks and Bolts, one of the few people who types in all caps. I enjoy it. Hello, Jacob. Nice to see you. I'm doing well. I hope you are as well. Jacob, good job rapping. Yeah, who dat? I'm the C-L-A-Y. Do that, yes. And in fact, some of Kayla's friends have sent me a video saying, who dat? I'm the C-L-A-Y, which is kind of funny. Dell, we were supposed to meet at Calgary at Vancouver 2 years ago. How are you holding up not being there live? I make a game an annual thing, but you being there all the time. Yeah, Dell, I'm okay. I would love to be there. But I also recognize that I'm very blessed to be able to afford both the time and the money to have season tickets. And we sell a few of our games, give away a few of our games, but I go to a lot. I go to more than my season ticket partner Mike does, for sure. So I'm okay. I would love to be there, obviously, especially because the Canucks are playing so well. I love meeting all of you at games like we were supposed to do 2 years ago. But I'm just fine. I really am. I feel more bad for the people who only get to go to one or two games a year. And if they had to miss any of these games recently, then I feel bad for them. I feel bad for families who can't go during the year but might buy tickets to games during the holiday break because it's less busy for them and better chance to go. So I'm doing fine. Thank you, Dell. I feel bad for others, to be honest. Carol, did I break my leg? No, I'm a machine. I'm Iron Man. I didn't even feel it. Noah, when did you go to your first Canucks game? Who did they play? Noah, sadly, I can't remember. I can't remember. I'm sure I was a young kid or in my teens, but I can't remember 30 years ago, admittedly. And maybe it wasn't that memorable, to be honest with you. So, yeah. Got to be honest. A van squad, van base. Very good, Coach Rob. No, Fangirl, I know you're not in a cast. I talked to you a couple days ago. Broke your arm in grade 7? Yes, a lot of kids break their arm. Rathbone is better than Hunt for sure. I agree, JGP. Jogpaul, I agree. I like Rathbone's game. Me too, Jogpaul. Arso, Wolf Fangirl, how long did it take to heal? Good question about the cast. Reaction Club, I was watching the Coyotes game last night. A few minutes after one of their goals, they played Whoomp, There It Is. Don't steal our song. Exactly. They got to know their role. They got to know their role for sure. Darren, will Besser be in the lineup at Florida? Yes. That's one. And that's what I vlogged about today. The blessings and the curse of these postponements. Besser should be cleared to play. Yeah, absolutely. Jason, do we know what the status is of the COVID protocol players? Besser and DiGiuseppe were first. They should be able to practice tomorrow. Dowling was the day after. He should be able to practice tomorrow. Dickinson, I believe, might still be in Seattle finishing off his COVID, his protocol. So I think you were looking at Besser, DiGiuseppe, and Dowling. So I think you bring Besser and Dowling in a lineup for sure. Knucks and Bolts, Canucks versus Panthers. Can the Canucks find their roar? Can they channel themselves like Katy Perry in the official roar? Yeah, Knucks and Bolts, you got a thing for Katy Perry, I think. 6 weeks in the cast for Fangirl. Jason was reading up on the practice and none of the protocol players. That's correct. So hopefully they're aiming for that tomorrow, for sure. Why can't Canucks play in an empty arena? They don't want to. They don't want to lose the money. Brian, so with the Canucks game postponed on Saturday, how many Canucks games have to be made up now? There are seven postponed, six home, one away. Alfred, what happens if game postponements accumulates even further? Do you think the NHL plans on finishing the season past June? They've already talked about perhaps extending by a week or so, Alfred. Edmund, hopefully Besser and Petey are back and healthy. Yeah, Petey probably can't play the Florida game, but maybe soon after that. Cole, what a tough road trip coming up. How crucial? I think we'll know, Cole. If they go 500 or more, then I'm going to bet on the team to make the playoffs for sure. I don't think they're going to go 0-5, but any type of losing record, it's so tough because we are right there. We're right on the cusp of catching San Jose, LA, Edmonton, Winnipeg, all those teams in the wild card race. Oh, Fango broke her arm just before vacation. How does the number 7 predictions holding up? Not sure what does that mean, nuts and bolts. Carol, how are they going to make it all these postponed games? You think they make it up? Yeah, they're going to try for sure. Hello, Lucas, welcome. You mean Aquilini doesn't. Yeah, fair. Brian, thanks for the answer. No problem. All right. Yes, let's welcome the legendary Lucas Gates in here. Travis, if the Calgary Flames overthrew the government made cheering for the Canucks a crime, would you break the law? Of course, I'd be prosecuted to the full extent. Okay, guys, I think it's time to give one or two of you a call. So this is what we're going to do. In the chat, ignore the fact that it says... I think I messed up again. Hold on. Ignore the fact that it says draw. There. That's good. Okay. If you want me to give you a call and we chat for 3 to 5 minutes right on the stream, because that I did this once before and everyone seemed to love it. If you want me to give you a call, so how should I say this? Make sure that you're allowed to chat. Like you're a teen or whatever. I don't want your parents getting mad at me for calling you. So make sure that you are able to chat. And it's not a video chat. It's phone call only. So go to that link that I just posted. It says Canuck Clay Draw, but there's no draw. It just says, that's just kind of the short name I've been using. It's simply going to ask for your name, your YouTube, your screen name, and then your phone number. That's it. You don't have to give me your email. And then in 5 minutes, I will pick someone at random to give you a call right on the stream here. So you don't have to. It's only if you want me to give you a call. You are welcome to, give me your info and I will see about giving you a call in about 5 minutes or so, okay? So once again, it's not mandatory. It's just if you want me to, and I'm gonna do it completely randomized. I'm gonna give someone a call right here. Fangirl, that would have sucked. Glad it healed quickly. RJ, don't call me. I'm not my Sunday best. Well, neither am I. No, I think I look okay. Justin, which memory sticks out more to you? Sedin 1,000 point on Luongo or Morrison's triple overtime winner versus Calgary to force game 7? Wow. To me, because I was there, it was Sedin's 1,000 point, Justin. But that triple overtime winner was pretty crazy. And there was more, technically, it was more important when you're talking about playoff ramifications, right? Yeah, good question. Good question, Justin. And you nominate. You can't nominate. Call Luongo. No, it's got to be someone on the stream. Okay, I'm seeing responses come in. So I'll give you guys two more minutes. If you want, I will give you guys a call. I'll give it 1.5 more minutes. Lucas, starting to think I had Omicron back in December. Was really sick back in December. Yeah, could very well be, Lucas. Could very well be, for sure. Yeah, I felt bad for Lucas. I felt bad for Jason, who I know felt bad for Lucas. But we're going to make it work. We're all smart people. We're going to make it work. Cal A, call me at a last resort. I had my chance last time. It's okay. Yeah, what I'll do is I will draw from here, and then I'll make sure that it's okay before I do it. No problem, Arsel. Last 30 seconds. Canucks winning 7 straight, NHL postponing the 7th day of January, which makes the 7th game. That's true. A lot of 7s in there, for sure. For sure. Okay, all right, so let me know. As soon as you're in, I will do this draw. I'm just waiting for the number to go up. Okay, there. I think Arsel's in. Okay, let me get this ready. So talk amongst yourselves for a minute. this is the only part that kind of stinks, because I have to download the thing. It doesn't, I mean, it stinks. It doesn't stink for me. It stinks for you that I'm sitting here clicking away, but I got to get this done. Okay. Let's see who's in here. Oh, shoot. Whoops. Almost ready. Okay, where are the ones from tonight? Okay. Okay, it's a good group. Okay. Okay, so I have to keep this screen open over here, just in case I actually need to phone one of you. Okay. So I'm going to put on the screen now the people who nominated themselves or who gave me the okay to call them. So let's get that on the screen in a second. Yeah, Jay, do you want me to put your name in? And welcome, Mike. Jason, I can put your name in as well. And I am driving a Pepsi today. I mean, not driving. Drinking. I'm drinking a Pepsi today. So Jason, just put in the chat if you want me to enter you in here. Okay. Yeah, Jason and I chat quite often, actually, and that was very kind of you. Okay, here we go, guys. There's my favorite. Now, everyone in here, you actually have a 1 in 9 chance. So Lucas, Gilbert, Cole, Justin, Edmund, Reaction Club, Kel, Shannon, and Arsel. So what I'll do is I will spin this, and then I would get a verbal from you in there, and then we will go from there. So here we go. This is for me to call you now. Shuffle, spin. Awesome. Okay, Reaction Club. Oh, I don't know if it's an actual winner, but Reaction Club, can you just confirm in the chat that that you're okay with me calling you? I'm sure you are. Otherwise, you wouldn't have put your name in there. But yes, Reaction Club, are you okay with me giving you a call? And then I will. So we'll just wait to hear from Reaction Club. I don't even know Reaction Club's real name. Oh yeah, I do now. Oh no, I don't. Oh yeah, I do. So just waiting for Reaction Club to put in the chat that I'm okay to call them. Unless he went away. Reaction Club, are you there? If we don't hear from Reaction Club in 30 seconds, we will draw another name. Uh-oh. Maybe I got stood up. Reaction Club, are you still in the chat? It's weird. He was in the draw. Okay, good. Okay, there we go. Thanks, Reaction Club. And okay, I will call you Reaction Club because I'm not sure if you want me to divulge your name. I know your name because you had to put it in the chat. But I will. So Reaction Club, I'm calling you right now and I'm putting you on speaker. Just keep it clean. Okay, give me 1 second. I just got to check one thing real quick. I just realized, not that Reaction Club is, but if any of you are long distance, next time I should probably put a disclaimer, then I would phone you a different way, like on WhatsApp or Facebook instead. Okay, here we go, Reaction Club. No. Gosh, I hope I don't dial the wrong number. I'd hate to wake someone up. Reaction Club? It's Canuck Clay. How are you, brother?
I'm good. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Can I? Do you want me to call you Reaction Club or your actual name? Which one would you prefer?
I don't mind. You can call me whichever one.
Okay, I'll call you Gurpreet because I'd like to give you your actual name. How are you, man?
Yeah. I'm good. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Thanks for entering. Thanks for being brave. So where are you calling from? Where do you live?
I live in Delta.
Oh, you're in Delta. Awesome. Do you mind me asking how old you are?
I'm 24.
Okay. I love getting to know the members and the viewers. So first and foremost, thank you for subscribing and thank you for always being on the streams. I really appreciate you.
Yeah, I always try to watch your streams whenever I can.
Thank you, Gurpreet. That's awesome. And then, you know, I'm gonna go here. And you're a good stand-up guy, even though when you spoiled that movie by accident.
Yeah, I know. I realized that after when I was going through the comments again, and I saw all those people that's coming back at me.
It was an honest mistake. And you know what's funny? That's the only movie I've seen in the past 6 months. So when that part happened in the movie and everyone else in the theater was, ooh, they're all getting excited, right? When I won't spoil it, but when that happened, I was kind of giggling inside because I remember that. So you're a good man for owning, and it was fine. So tell us a bit about yourself. How long have you been a Canucks fan?
I've been a Canucks fan since probably around 2010, 2011, around the time that they made the Stanley Cup run.
Yeah, so then back then you were obviously, 13 or 14 years old, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. And did you go to school, school in Delta?
Yeah, I went to school here called Burnsview Secondary.
Okay, very cool. And then you graded, you obviously graded then about 6 years ago then.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so who's your favorite Canucks player right now?
Right now, I would probably say JT Miller.
Oh, why?
He's the one that I like the most.
Awesome.
I just think that he's a great player, and I've been following him ever since he was on the Rangers.
Right. So I'm guessing you certainly don't want him to get traded or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
I was actually when he signed with us, I was actually really excited when he signed with us. So without a trade talk going on about him being traded, I actually don't want him to get traded.
Yeah, no, me neither. And I as you know, I vlog about that quite a lot because I think it's ridiculous. But I can see why, right? Because he's worth so much on a good contract. But that's kind of the guy you want on your team as well, isn't it?
Yeah. And plus he also makes a lot of plays that are highlight reels.
Yeah. No, it's true. He's a really, really smart player and underrated in some respects for sure. Okay. So a couple more questions. And then, do you think this break is good for the Canucks or bad for the Canucks?
I don't know. I think it can go both ways. I think we can have a chance of, having all of our players, return from the COVID COVID.
Yeah.
And it could be bad just because I think maybe having a too long of a break, some of our players could be slow again.
Well, well said, man. I should get you to do my vlogs for me, man. Okay, and lastly, I don't know if you've seen any of my Zoom chats. I always end off with the five hole. It's five rapid fire questions. Can I give them to you? Is that cool?
Yeah.
Okay. Number one, what's the best sport that you play? What sport are you best at playing?
I would say hockey.
Nice. Number two, you're starting a franchise. Quinn Hughes or Elias Pettersson?
Hughes.
Okay. Number three, Chinese food or Japanese food?
I like both, but the one I eat more is Chinese.
Okay. I still like you. Don't worry. I'll forgive you. No, it's fine. I'm just kidding. Number four, this question. Okay. Would you rather go to dinner with Bruce Boudreaux, Francesco Accolini, or Jim Rutherford?
Boudreaux.
Okay.
From his press conference, he just seems like a really fun guy to be around.
Yep, I love it. And lastly, what's one thing that you're going to share with these YouTube viewers? What's one thing about you? Tell us something cool about you.
One thing about me is that I can probably share is that when I became a Canucks fan, I actually didn't really know a lot about them. It's just a bunch of my friends who were Canucks fans before, and they used to talk a lot about them.
Yeah.
And then me and my family watched the Canucks regularly during their Stanley Cup run in the 2011 season.
Yeah.
And then after the 2011 season, after they lost, my family just stopped watching the Canucks, but I still remained their Canucks fan since then.
So you're admitting that your family were bandwagon jumpers, but you stayed on.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. Hey, Gurpreet, I really appreciate your support. Thank you for also, you know, throwing your name here so I can give you a call. And thanks for everything, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, we'll talk soon. I'll see you back in the chat.
Okay.
Okay, thanks a lot. Take care.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye. All right, that was cool. That was cool. He's a real fan for sure. And I love this. I love the chance to just chat with people and get to know some of the people who've been supporting me for a long time. So thank you, Gurpreet. Okay, we're going to do one more video, then we're going to do one more call. Sound good? Doesn't matter. I'm going to do it anyways. Okay. This video, this video is pretty funny. This video is a family video. And let me just pull it up here. And I'll explain it real quick. This one's 2.5 minutes as well, so it's quick. But it's one of our favorite videos that we've done as a family. And it's Jacob. So this is my middle son, Jacob. And this was when he was in elementary school and he got a bunch of stitches on his forehead because he ran into a pole when he was playing a game of what he called hide and go tag. I guess it's a combination of hide and seek and tag. So this is Jacob explaining how he got his stitches. Enjoy, 2.5 minutes long.
Hey, Jake.
Hey.
What's on your head?
I had stitches.
How many stitches you got?
5.
All right, tell us what happened.
So I was running and playing with my friends after school. We were playing hide and go tag, and I thought...
Hide and go tag?
Yeah. So I thought they were going to tag me, and I wasn't looking, so I ran into a pole. Then I fell down, and parents came to me, and I was bleeding, and it was so deep. I had to go to hospital, and they put a special blanket on me where there's a hole inside so they could just see my stitches. So they, when I was breathing inside the blanket, the first needle was a little bit scary. I thought it would hurt this hard, but a shot hurt this hard, and it only hurt this hard. So they put special cream, and it hurt, and they put it on my stitches. So they put it on, and it didn't, when they did it, it didn't hurt very bad.
So how are you feeling now?
Pretty good. This eye feels sleepy, but this one doesn't.
Which eye feels sleepy?
Mm-hmm.
Which eye feels sleepy? Okay. Do you think it makes you look tough?
Not really.
Do you think more girls are gonna like you now?
No.
How many girlfriends do you have?
30?
Yeah. Okay, so you don't need any more girlfriends.
But.
Okay, do you have anything else you want to say about your head or about stitches or about hide and go tag?
My friend Theo in grade 3 had stitches. He has long hair, but he's a boy. It's up to here. And the stitches was right here, so he covered it. That's why he wanted long hair.
Oh, but you can't cover your stitches.
Yeah, because I don't have long hair yet.
It's okay. You look good.
Hey, bye, guys. Bye, guys.
Thanks.
You're welcome, guys.
Ah, yes. So that was Jake in 2010. He was in grade 1. A couple things I want to point out. He's very expressive when he was explaining his injuries. And he talked about... he talked about the little... Jacob, are you down here? Thanks for letting me show that. You have any comments? Okay. People liked it. So he was talking about the blanket, the, you know, the sheet that they use in the hostel where they just kind of, I guess, put it right over the wound so they can work on it. So that he also talked about his friend Theo, who was actually in Sean's grade, who had longer hair, who was able to cover his stitches with his long hair. But of course, Jacob, as he said, I don't have long hair. So yes, that was Jacob. He was just as he is now. He was quite the character when he was younger. And yeah, I just thought I always want to I'll probably do two videos for every one of these Friday Night Lives, one music video and then one video from back in the day. Not to embarrass anyone, but I had a lot of fun with that one. It sounds like you guys like that one too. So Kel says, LOL, the background music. RJ says, Buahaha, this is the best. Hospital, yes, in the hospital. Fangirl says, oh, young Jacob, JGP, LOL, Timberland music behind traumatic story. Also, LOL, truly Canadian from a young age. Jason, these videos must bring back some serious memories. Yes, and not all good ones. Coach Rob, a brave boy. I would be so scared. Jacob is a brave boy. Marcus, how many times did Clay embarrass him with the girlfriend questions back then? No, I was proud, and Jacob was proud. Yes, he ranged from anywhere between 3 and 30 girlfriends in elementary school, which is quite impressive. Nucks and bolts, stitches are a part of growing up. Yes, my worst stitches had 2 in my eyelid. I've told the story before on the stream. I was playing street hockey. I stupidly went behind a guy who was going to do a backhand. He didn't know I was behind him. His stick came up, caught me across the side of my head. So I got a scar on one of my I only have one forehead, on one side of my forehead, and I had 2 stitches. So I was lying there on the pavement with a bleeding eyelid. My dad brought me in and lied me down on the bed. My mom was freaking out, and then I had to go to the hospital to get 2 stitches in my eyelid. Lucas says, that was cute. Thank you. Arsenal said, too good. Edmund says, oh, Jacob. Shannon, that is so cute the way he explains how it hurt. This big or this big? Yeah, that was cute. They grew up so fast. I agree, Edmund. Jason, and now you got a superstar bowler. Yes, number one bowler in the country for his age. Record holder. Nucks and Bolts, wait for him to get the vaccination mark. I'm not sure if we're going to make a video about that. Jason, where are the kids? Sean making a guest appearance. No, I don't like to spring it on them, so I'll have to try and plan that better. Justin says, so adorable. Yeah, Jacob was a cute kid. Kel, well, Jacob picked up more girls than I have in my lifetime. Jacob, you like that one? Jacob's listening. He liked that one, Kel. He liked that one. You didn't have 30 girlfriends. Yeah. Edmund says, stitches gave you the bowling powers. And then Fangirl, one of my siblings needed stitches when they were younger. Yikes. Okay. So I wrap up by 12. By 12. What am I talking about? It's already 11:48. We're going to do one more call. So let's do that now. Marcus, what an absolute player. Yes, he gets it from his dad. No, I'm just kidding. What am I talking about? Let's go to our wheel of names one more time. So I got to remove Reaction Club. Oh, I don't think I did. I think I just do this manually. Okay. All right, so one more call. And I will confirm with you that it's still okay to call because it's a little later now. We're getting close to midnight. Reaction Club says, Gurpreet, I am honored to be the first winner on this call thing. Marcus, you put your... Okay, I will do this. Right now, really quickly, put it in the chat for the next... So now you've seen how it goes. It's about 5 minutes, very non-threatening. If anyone who did not... whose name isn't on there now and you are in here and you missed it, just tell me now. I'll type in your name and then if you win, you'll have to somehow get me your number. So I'll put Marcus in here right now. So Marcus is in there. Would anyone else want to join that's not in there? So Coach Rob, you want in there? Okay. Tasty Twins. I'm not sure if I'll be voting Tasty or Twins if you guys win, but that's fine. Numbers in the survey, good. Jason Clay. This is the first. Oh. Okay, Jay, text me so we don't negotiate in front of everyone. Text me what you're willing to give away. Stats machine. Okay. Okay. So here's what we do, you guys. 30 more seconds. Put your name in the chat. Then if I've acknowledged you and you're, if you see your name on the screen now, I need you to go to that link and sign the form so I have your phone number. So Coach Rob, Marcus, Tasty Twins, Stats Machine, go to that link and put your, make sure you fill out that link so I have your phone number just in case you do win. Okay, I'm going to put Carol in as well. So those of you that got in the first time, you had the advantage that there was only half the people. Yeah, Jay, text me, and then we're going to have to figure out how to do that too. Yeah, so I got Carol's name, and I just typed it in. Texting you now. Okay, we will close it there. So I will spin it now, and then I will give this person a call. Here we go. And there you go. Last one in gets the call. So Carol, I have your number already. I'm going to give you a call in a minute. Give me a second. And you guys are in for a treat. Carol is a wonderful... Carol's hilarious. This is going to be a lot of fun. Carol, give me a second. I just got to text Lucas something. Not Lucas. Jason something real quick. And then we will do a draw. Okay. So Carol, I'm going to give you a call. Yeah, these calls are a little silly, but I think they're kind of fun. All right, Carol. Hopefully you're around. And hopefully you answer. I'm just going to call you.
Hello?
Carol.
Hey.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. And you are, as everyone knows, a hero member, newly minted, and we have our chat on Sunday, so we won't spoil what we're going to talk about on Sunday, but thank you for your support as always, Carol.
Oh, you're very welcome.
And before we have some fun, I saw the serious note that you, well, firstly, I'm glad that you got into this chat. You got in the contest. It's not even a contest. Do you feel like you're a winner, though, with this call?
Sure thing.
But thank you for entering your name. I saw that you have to, you had to move in 2 months. Is everything okay?
Well, I had a flood, and then the owners wanted to poop me out.
And so they gave you 2 months?
Yep.
Do you think you get any leniency on that, or do you think they're going to be pretty strict on that?
Well, they've been trying to get me out for a year and a half.
Okay. Gotcha.
Because of the circumstances.
Yeah.
But anyway, I'm just going to keep looking.
Okay, well, we won't get into it too much here, but we'll talk through it more on Sunday if that's cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, but yes, you're getting a lot of empathy in the chat. You know, people want it to work out for you, obviously. So.
Thank you, everybody.
We'll wait to hear good news, okay?
Yeah, that'd be great.
All right, what do you got planned for the weekend?
Well, I was going to watch the Canucks.
I know, you and me both. And I know there's a bunch of people in here that were supposed to go to the game, so.
Well, that's really too bad.
Yeah. What do you think about this team?
I love our team, but, you know, like I said in the chat, I'm worried about them getting all their games caught up.
Okay, so you're not even worried that they're going to lose momentum or that they're going to lose. You're more worried that they might not even get their games in.
Right.
And then if they did that, the Canucks, I mean, the league would have to do what they did 2 years ago and then find an appropriate cutoff, right? Find out how to determine who makes the playoffs. But I hear what you're saying. That's fair. I'm guessing Boudreaux's your kind of guy?
I really like him. I think he's got a great head on his shoulders.
Yeah, I agree. And tell everyone, I know the story because we've talked a couple times already, but tell everyone very quickly about your fandom, how long you've been a fan for.
I've been a fan since 1970.
Wow. Wow.
From the very beginning.
Wow.
I remember watching the first game.
God bless you. God bless you.
You too.
Oh, no, but, no, but that's amazing. Since 1970.
Yeah.
So you could teach Gurpreet's family a thing or two. I'm just kidding. Gurpreet was great.
You got to stick with the team, buddy. You got to stick with the team.
No, I think Gurpreet's fine. I think it's his family. Those are the ones. No, that's hilarious. so aside from the Canucks game, what else did you have planned for this weekend?
Oh, I've been just watching a lot of movies.
Oh, yeah. Like what?
I like sci-fi. I like Star Wars. And,
okay.
And Star Trek stuff. And
cool.
Action movies. I like a lot of action.
Oh, me too. Well, you're getting a lot of love in the chat, too. Speaking of action, saying that it's cool that you've been a season ticket holder since you've been a fan since 1970. Marcus called you a legend. Justin says best wishes. You can see these on.
Thank you yep. so much, everybody.
Brian says awesome. J Kid says hope you find a new place. Shannon says sorry to hear. Hope you find a place. So there's a lot of love in this community. Isn't that cool?
That is awesome. Thank you so much, everybody.
Awesome. Okay.
Greatly appreciate it. And God bless everybody.
Oh, that's awesome. Hey, can we wrap up with the five hole as well with you?
Sure thing.
Okay. What was the best sport either now or when you were in your athletic days or playing sports? What's the best sport that you're – what's your best sport?
I played floor hockey using my crutches.
Wait, did you still have a stick or did you just use your crutch as your stick?
I just used my crutches and I used it as a stick.
Was that legal?
Oh, yeah, sure.
So at least you'd never get a high sticking penalty.
Well, that's true because I had to – hold myself up?
Yep. Wow. You get a high crutching penalty, but that's another story. Okay.
Yeah, that's another story, yeah.
Number two, you're starting a team from scratch. Quinn Hughes or Elias Pettersson?
Quinn Hughes.
And would you say that even before this season started?
Yeah,
okay.
I would.
Okay. Why?
Because I think it's really important to have a really good defenseman, and I like him.
Okay. I love it.
I think he's young and he's got a lot of guts.
I love it. Number three, Chinese food or Japanese food?
Chinese food.
Ah, dang. Okay, that's fine. You know I like Japanese food a bit more, but that's fine. I still love you. Okay, number four, speaking of food, who would you rather go out for dinner with? Boudreaux, Aquilini, or Jim Rutherford, our new president?
I think I'd go with the coach.
Yeah? I could see you guys having a good time.
Yeah, I would have a lot of questions.
I'm sure you have a lot of answers. That's awesome. Lastly, Carol, what's one thing that you want this community to know about you?
Well, I really love the Canucks, and I'm really loyal, and I really looking forward to making friends.
Awesome, Carol. Well, thank you. Thanks for everything. The community appreciates you, and I appreciate you. You know that, and I will I'll see you on the stream for a couple more minutes, but then I'll talk to you on Sunday. Sound good?
You bet. Thank you so much.
Okay, thanks for being so open, Carol. Take care.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. That's awesome. Okay. You guys, talk amongst yourselves. Maybe drop some love for Carol in the chat. I need to update the sign-up sheet, and then we are going to end off our first Friday Night Live with the giveaway. So talk to Carol in the chat. Talk to each other. I need about 2 minutes, okay? I know this isn't great, but this is worth it. Trust me. I just got to update one thing here. Whoops. I think we're good. Okay, friends. Yeah, that was a great call. Thank you, Carol. Okay, to wind up, a wonderful way to wind up, you must once again, even if you gave me your info, it's gone now. So everyone, if you want to enter into the draw, go to that link right now and type in your info. Even all the people that did it before, so Cole, Lucas, Gilbert, Arsenal, Justin, Shannon, Edmund, Kel, Marcus, Coach Rob, Tasty Twins, everyone, you all need to go to that link now and type in new info, okay? So make sure you do that now to enter the contest. I'm just reading through my, don't worry, I'm going to give you 5 minutes to do that. It should only take you a minute. It's just your name, your YouTube name here, your email, and your phone number. So go to the link that I just typed. It's also pinned up there. Go there and make sure you fill in your info. And this is your reward for being here at midnight at... No, Lucas, I'm going to give people some time. You're just saying that because you were the first one in. Okay, so Jason sent me a few funny messages here, but what we are going to draw for is a $50 gift card to anywhere you want that we can buy online. So $50 gift card, it could be Starbucks, it could be Amazon, it could be McDonald's, it could be Best Buy, it could be Costco. If you're the more practical, it could be Superstore, it could be Kohl's. Whoa, Justin. And some love for Justin. Okay, so this, Justin, just to clarify, is this money, do you want me to send this to Carol directly? Or do you want me to, Justin, send me a message. I want to make sure that I honor your wishes. Because it says, not much, but Carol, hope it helps a bit, whether it be for bills or whatever you need. So I guess this money is supposed to go to Carol, and I will happily make that happen if that's indeed the case. Yeah, Justin, sorry if I missed. Yeah, Justin, just let me know, and I'm happy to make that happen for sure. Thank you for the donation, Justin, especially if it's to go to Carol. That's amazing stuff. Okay. And it sounds like Jason's going to get you a t-shirt or an umbrella or two. So this is what we're going to do for this contest. I see about 25 of you entered, which is cool. I'll give you two more minutes. $50 gift certificate to wherever you want. Oh, and then another donation from Lucas Gates. Thank you, Lucas. I appreciate it. So Carol, when I talk to you on Sunday, we'll figure something out. Yeah, because I don't want to put anyone in a weird situation where they have to type in. Yeah, Justin, just message me directly if that makes sense. But thank you, Justin, for the donation. Thank you, Lucas, for the donation. Appreciate you guys. Legends coming through tonight, which is pretty cool. That's why they are indeed legends. Okay, we better get to this. Otherwise, you guys are going to say this is going too long. I was actually only going to go for about half an hour, but between the two videos, the two phone calls, that already takes up 20 minutes already. Okay, so let's do this. $50 gift card to wherever you want. All you got to do is, if you have Instagram, follow Van City Experts on Instagram. And Jason's so cool. He's not even gonna check if you're doing this or not. He's just asking you to, if you're getting $50 from him, I guess that's the least we can all do. So I'm gonna put it in the chat, Van City Experts. Let me just put it. So if you, whoops, I'm going crazy here. If you are on Instagram, follow Van City Experts. So I just put that in. Also, if you're on Instagram, follow me. And that's all you got to do to win this contest. And you know, I'm not even going to check. Like, it's not like we're going to draw the winner and then we're going to make sure that you're following both accounts. We're just going to go honor system here. Hey, Sean. So I'm doing this 24, I mean, not 24 hour. That's crazy. I'm doing my first Friday Night Live. We watched The Comfy. We watched Jacob Explain His Stitches. I've made 2 phone calls. People are donating money. They're helping out a fellow subscriber. And now Jason donated a $50 gift cert as a giveaway. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Okay. So once again, okay, wow, okay, I gotta write this down here. So we have another $20 donation to Carol. Carol, you should do a YouTube channel. This is pretty good. And it says from Shannon Clay, please send this to Carol from Rob and Charlie. Love you, Carol. That is awesome. This is pretty cool. This is no, Kel. It's okay if you don't use Instagram. That's fine. No, you can still be in here for sure. I should have did my whole song and dance to make sure you've only entered once, but I will check that. So once again, $50 gift certificate, place of your choice. We ask that you follow Van City Experts on Instagram. We ask that you follow Clayton Emo on Instagram. We're not even gonna check. That's how much we believe in you guys. But yes, make sure that you're following both of us. And we have $50 to Carol from Justin, $20 to Carol from Shannon. Lucas, message me with your... And Lucas, another $5 donation. That is awesome. Okay, we should probably do this draw, eh? So we can get out of here soon. So let's get to it. So once again, talk amongst yourselves as I get these... Okay, last call. Last call, I'll give it 30 more seconds and then I'm closing it off. Last call to go to that website, tinyurl.com/CanuckClayDraw. Last chance to get your name in to win $50 gift certificate. Again, we just ask that you follow Van City Experts on Instagram and you follow Clayton Emo on Instagram. Wow, this is cool. This is really cool tonight, you guys. And you can see why... Another $10 for Carol. Awesome. Thank you, Coach Rob. And Travis Green. So let's get some love for Coach Rob. And we also have a new member. Travis Green joins as an all-star member. That is awesome. Let's get some love for both Coach Rob and for Travis Green. Okay. Now I'm going to pull these responses. So talk amongst yourselves one more time. I got to come up with a new... So much for 11:30. This is crazy. Okay, I got to download this now. And then I'll put everyone into my famous wheel here. Oh, shoot. I got to close my old one. Don't save. Okay, now let's try this. I'm excited, you guys. I'm excited. Notice how much more casual I was with these entries. Remember last time we were talking for the tickets, like, oh, you can't sell these. Oh, you can only enter once. Oh, da da da. But this one was a little bit more chill, which is good. But I am gonna still make sure there's no duplicates, for sure. And then we will get going. Data sort. I'm excited, you guys. I like doing draws. We should do more of these more often. So once again, Lucas, thank you for your generosity as always. Oh, shucks, you guys. I just messed up. Hold on. I'm just milking the... Okay, here. Oh, good. You know what? It's funny about these contests too, is then I see people that were in the chat, or at least here, but haven't chatted yet. Marcus, thank you for that donation for Carol. You guys, we have raised $85 for Carol on here, which is pretty amazing. No, I'm not going for another hour, Steve. That's crazy. Yes, this is, I say it all the time, and it's not just a shtick. I think, I definitely think this is the best Canucks community on YouTube by far. And yes, Jason, I think the winner has to be in the chat. That's true. That's true. Although I'm pretty sure they're probably sticking around to see if they win, considering that it's worth $50. Okay. Enough blabbing. We better do this, you guys. I will never finish a stream in half an hour. I think I talk too much. But that's a good thing, right? You don't want to be on a stream where... Okay, so I'm going to show you everything. I'm going to show you the magic. Here we go. Okay. Blank wheel. Not a blank wheel. Okay, friends. This is for a $50 gift certificate. I'm going to shuffle three times. And then I will contact you. And we'll figure out how to do this. Again, the winner, I appreciate you. If you're following Van City Experts on Instagram, you're following me on Instagram. And hopefully you are here. Marcus. I'm because of that comment, I'm taking Marcus's name out of this draw. I'm just kidding. I'm totally kidding. Well, Mark is very bold. And I think Mark is only like 18 or 19 years old too. Okay, here we go. Let's see who wins this thing. Congratulations, Brian. It was almost Kel, but the wheel had other plans. That's awesome, Brian. I know that you're always on the stream. You're always very supportive. Brian, can you confirm that you are still here on the chat? Yeah, it's all good, Marcus. Brian, can you confirm that you were in the chat still? Yeah, Kel, so close. Okay, sweet. Okay. That is awesome. Okay. I gotta stop saying okay. That's one of my word whiskers. Oh, do I still have the thing on the... No. My screen's behind. My friends, this is pretty awesome. So this is what we're gonna do. Michael, I think I have your email address now. I will get you the $50 VanBase gift card for winning my December post-game contest. Brian, I will contact you and shoot me a message. No, I will email you first, Brian, and then you can shoot me a message and let me know exactly what gift card you would like. Because we're not just going to send you, we're not going to send you the $50 just directly. Not that you want that. We will buy you a gift card to somewhere. Jason, thank you very much. Jason Lim of Van City Experts, thank you very much for sponsoring that very, very impromptu giveaway. I appreciate it. And for everyone who gave donations, the donations tonight, majority of them going to Carol to try and help her out in her situation as she is having to move in the next 2 months. And we pray that she finds a place to stay, somewhere that's affordable and safe. And Carol, I will talk to you more about it on Sunday for sure. But for everyone who gave donations tonight for Carol, I know Justin did. Lucas, Marcus, Coach Rob, and Shannon. Awesome stuff. Well, this was pretty cool, you guys. This was a wonderful night. More than the fun videos, more than the small sliver of Canucks talk, even more than the phone calls, which is the way that we came together tonight. And yeah, it's not about me. I'm not here to try and get donations, likes, subscriptions. All those things are nice, but it's even better when we can help someone else. So this was great tonight. This was very, very redeeming, heartwarming, blessed, whatever word you want to use. A wonderful way to start the weekend. I don't know if it's the best. Brian, what are you saying? Brian, are you saying give your... Yeah, I don't want to put words in your mouth, Brian. It says, cool, give it, Carol. I'm not sure. Are you saying give your $50 gift card to Carol? Brian, can you confirm that one more time? Just because I don't want to say the wrong thing, nor am I putting pressure on you to do so at all, Brian. But if you can confirm that, because I know your messages are a couple seconds behind, delayed from when... I talk, so I don't want to say the wrong thing. Carol, you forgot your email. No, don't worry. Well, no, I have your email, Carol. I have it. I have it. Or, Carol, do you want me to put your email in the chat? All right, so now we got a couple things going on. Brian, confirm with me that you want to gift your gift card to Carol, but there's no pressure to do so. So I don't want you to put you in a funny spot. Carol, let me know if you want me to put your email in the chat. Or I'm not sure if you were saying that because people want to support, in case people want to support you, I can put your email in the chat. So I'll wait for those two answers and then we will wrap up. And Brian, I can also, not to put you on the spot, I can just message you directly too. Wow, you guys. Wow. What? I'm very touched. Brian is donating his gift card to Carol. So Brian, who won the $50 gift card, is gifting that to Carol, which is pretty amazing. Wow, you guys, I'm touched. This is pretty cool. This is pretty cool. I would dare say because this was as good as the 24-hour live stream. A lot shorter. I'm not falling asleep in front of you, but the amount of charity and the amount of love for your fellow Canucks fans. Pretty solid. So we're going to give all donations from tonight to Carol. So that's $100 worth of donations that we're going to give to Carol. And we're also going to give her the $50 gift card. So pretty amazing. Pretty amazing. Yeah, this is a good stream. You guys tell all your... We're not going to, we're not going to put any expectations on future streams because we want to keep these organic. You know, we're not going to walk in here every Friday and say, this is who or what we're going to donate to. But if things happen organically, you know, this is the last thing I'll say. I walked in here excited, not nervous. I never get nervous, but I walked in here excited and admittedly, not with a master plan. I knew I showed those two videos. Obviously, I had them prepped. I knew we were going to do a phone call or two. And we have a new all-star member as well. MD's on Junior. Welcome. Welcome. I had a plan of how I want to do it, but I said right from the start, I want to make this different from Sunday and Wednesday nights in how organic it is. Not really putting a time limit or expectation and just kind of seeing what happens. Well, tonight, what happened was amazing. It was amazing. And I'm going to remember this night for a long time to come. So Carol, on Sunday, when we have our member chat, I'll figure out how to get this money to you and we will go from there. So Brian, thank you for donating your gift card to Carol. Lucas, Justin, Coach Rob, Shannon, and Marcus, thank you for your generosity in donating to Carol tonight. And Jason, thank you for providing the gift card that we were able to do so. To all my new members, MDs on Junior and Travis Green, thank you as well. And you know, I think it's time to wrap up. And I'm in a pretty hype mood. I would almost want to go for another hour, but no, I better get upstairs, get some rest. Thank you, everyone. This was amazing. This was really, really cool. We won't try and top it next Friday. We'll just treat every Friday like its own thing. But I couldn't have asked for a better start to Friday Night Live. And don't worry, I'm certainly not going to cheat you out of a dad joke to end off as well. So, moderators, thank you. Thankfully, we didn't do too much tonight. Members, thank you. New subscribers, thank you. New members, thank you. Everyone who donated, especially to Carol, thank you. Jason, thank you. Perform and Transform, Gassy Jack, Art Monkey 9. And most importantly, to all of you, thank you for being here. Thank you for making this night so special, so memorable. Can't wait to do it all again next Friday. And don't worry, you will get your dad joke. But yes, this is pretty cool. And lastly, if you want to... Yeah, okay, we'll leave it there. I'll just complicate things more. So thanks, everyone, for being here. No Canucks game tomorrow. I know, but find, you know, put your energy into something else, something productive. And as always, stay safe, stay healthy, take care of yourselves, and take care of each other. Very quickly, what do you call a sad cup of coffee? Depresso. God bless, and go Canucks go. Booyah.